IT was Andrew's Day on the BBC today. Not St. Andrew's Day, that was 24 hours before. This was another Andrew. Lots of Andrews, indeed. There was Andrew Marr, who was interviewing Boris Johnson on the Andrew Marr Show. Andrew Marr wanted to know if Mr. Johnson would appear on the Andrew Neil interviews, as Scotland's First Minister Nicola Sturgeon and Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn had done. The PM said he was happy to sit down with any interviewer called Andrew from the BBC. Which is not the same as saying he will go on Neil's show. He could have been pledging to sit down with Andrew Kerr, Andrew Black, Andrew Thomson, Andrew Anderson, Andrew Picken, and that's just for starters at BBC Scotland. Auntie has lots of sons called Andrew. She may even have daughters, too. Why, at this very minute, Emily Maitlis or Emma Barnett could be changing their names to Andrew to secure that coveted one-to-one with the PM. It may seem odd for the media to be gazing at its own navel in this way, but as anyone who lived through the War of Jennifer's Ear and Bigotgate will attest, it is not an election proper until journalists have joined in the fighting. Channel 4 felt the heat last week after replacing a no-show Boris Johnson with an ice sculpture in a climate change debate. Not to be outdone, the BBC managed to get itself embroiled in argy-bargy over its Andrews. At first, it seemed Auntie had sorted matters. Appear on Neil's show, the BBC told Downing Street, or forget about Marr. It was a bold position which duly crumbled on Saturday afternoon when the BBC said that following Friday's terrorist attack at London Bridge it was now in the public interest for the PM to be on Marr. Cue outrage from Labour and others, accusing the corporation of caving in. Come 9 a.m. Sunday, all eyes that were open and focused were trained on Marr's show. Given the pressing national interest, the producers surely would not keep us waiting. Oh. But they did, forcing the viewer to sit through interviews with Labour's Sharmi Chakrabarti and the Lib Dems' Chuka Yamuna. It was like turning up to see the big movie only to be hit with 8 hours of adverts. Finally, at 47 minutes past the hour, it was on. Johnson v. Marr, the Englishman against the Scotsman. There was a lot at stake. Not the security of the nation or the country's economic prospects. This was far more serious than any of that. This was about ego. Mr. Johnson had to show that he was not scared of blokes called Andrew, and a bloke called Andrew wanted to show him that he jolly well should be scared of blokes called Andrew. Consider, if you will, how Marr might have felt as the row over the Neil show raged. Both big beasts in the jungle of political journalism, yet there he was, by implication the softer option in comparison with his fellow countrymen. If that was not the case, why would Downing Street say for more on this story, visit the news article link.